Yesterday we heard a beautiful conversation, a reflection by Cardinal Di Nardo on Saint Joseph, a wonderful man of faith who totally believed in God, and because of his faith in God, his trust in his goodness, he loved God with all of his being, with all of his mind, with all of his soul, with everything that he was. And in God he loved Mary, again with all of his being, because Mary was to become and indeed became his wife. And by loving God and loving Mary, he became the one who welcomed Jesus into this world, the Son of God incarnate in Jesus. And Joseph, in that way, as we remember and from the readings from yesterday, really epitomizes in a beautiful way, in a quiet way, in a very active way, nevertheless, the man, the person who brings together the two commandments. What is the first commandment? What is the second commandment? Asks the man, Jesus, and Jesus answered, the first is, love God with all your being and love your neighbor as yourself. Joseph is truly a model for us, who believes and then loves, and then acts out his love. Brothers and sisters, we have to acknowledge that these days are not common days. I dare say, that's my personal conviction, that we really are living a unique stage of human history. It's not just you and me here in Houston. It's not just my relatives back home in Italy. It's pretty much across the world. We are surrounded by an enemy that brings death and yet is invisible. Invisible and yet deadly. And we do not know what to do. Of course, we are told what we cannot do, and we better observe those norms for our own safety. But among the things that we cannot do, now we know that we cannot, for some time, receive the Eucharist. We cannot participate in the Eucharistic celebrations. And that never happened before, typically, in our lives, that we cannot do so. And we wonder, where is God? How can I find God? How can I be connected to God at a time when the most beautiful and fundamental way to connect with God is no longer available? Sure, I as a priest celebrate the Mass every day. Now I can celebrate it with some of my confreres. But most of you, or the vast majority, do not. So how can we continue with this? Well, the first thing that I want to say to you is that, and can never be taken away from us, is that God loves us. God loves us freely. That's what Hosea said to his people of Israel. God loves you freely. Therefore, three things. One, become aware that God loves you. Become aware of the different means and ways through which God shows love to you, family members, people, the nature, and now even this particular fear that orients us more towards him. Then thank God for it. Be really always grateful that God loves you and never ceases, never stops loving you. And finally, go out and love your neighbor as yourself. Be gentle, be kind, be patient, be active, be happy, joyful, be all of the good things that love brings about. So, would you repeat it with me? Become aware that God loves you. Be grateful and say thank God that he loves you, and then go out and love. Have a beautiful, wonderful day in God's love.